Explain to us what is happening here now.
So we have a conference. Yeah. We are a project with worldwide volunteers, and we're together working on a free operating system. And here we are actually meeting in person. So people from all over the world have come here, and so we're meeting in person to work together on those things. And it's very effective to work together, because normally we talk together via the internet, but here you can actually put all the people in a room and we can discuss various things. So that's very helpful. And so basically we have a conference with talks where people talk about various things, and then we have Debian camp where we just sit together and work together on various things. And we've done that for the fifth time now. So we've had a conference in Norway last year, and we've been in Canada the year before. And it has always been very efficient to like get together and work on things, and it's also very fun, because usually we work together by the internet, so we don't actually know those people, and now we actually meet each other and go out for a beer. So it's really good to meet people.
And why did you choose Brazil this time?
Every year someone else organizes it, and this year someone in Brazil said we're gonna organize it, and they did all of the work, so they did a really good job. And we try to always have the conference at a different place, so it's always moving, and because it's a good opportunity to visit another country and to see, get a good impression about other countries.
A quarta DebConf, Conferência Mundial de Desenvolvedores Debian GNU Linux, aconteceu em Porto Alegre, no SESC. A conferência reuniu, pela primeira vez no Brasil, os maiores desenvolvedores do projeto Debian no mundo, que durante os dias do evento, discutiram não somente códigos e ferramentas mais eficazes, mas também a responsabilidade que está inserida no contexto social das ações praticadas por eles. O projeto Debian GNU Linux é mais do que algumas milhares de pessoas desenvolvendo um sistema operacional ou ferramentas como Office em licença livre. É também um movimento social.
I am not directly involved in social things as a part of Debian, but as a part of my private life. Being part of Debian gives me more technical meanings, technical ways of creating things. So, for example, one thing that I do using Debian structure is customizing Debian to create a software that can be used by civil society to work better. All that table that you see there is people like me that want to bring their knowledge into Debian in creating something that can help small groups and political organizations in having a better tools to their work, both communications over the internet or work inside the organization. It's quite interesting, because if you want to work socially, you have to respect the local aspect of the people who will work with the software, and you have a new way of working. You're not a business anymore. You are part of the social movement itself, and there are new interesting challenges that come and that we are identifying and discovering on the way. So now there's a lot of talking about civil society. There's a lot of talking about information society. And information society is all this involvement of computer technology and information technology in the contemporary society, it's changing the way we communicate, we get together. Actually, I'm here in Porto Alegre, I'm from Italy, working together with people from like all around the world. So we are talking globalization, we are talking communication infrastructure, we work together, all these people work together every day over the internet. So we are in a kind of new small revolution, or small or big, we still don't know. And this involves social changes.
Yeah.
When something involves social changes, well, it's part of our freedom. Part of our freedom is the duty of being attentive of what happens and trying to make it become better. So that's why I think many people, probably in Porto Alegre first, because I know you are doing it since at least 99, the FISL forum is going on. But besides Porto Alegre, all around the world, people are getting aware of that and are trying to see how globalization and information society can be made better, can be made good, and bring on this. So we started, personally, I started working with local groups in the city, trying to help small radios or fair trade shops in creating the infrastructure they needed. And then we started working with civil society groups to teach them how to use free software, with the idea that if you are creating a better world, then you must start being a better world yourself. And so starting being able to use the better world tools for computer as well.
Hello, my name is Amaya Rodrigo. I'm from Spain. I'm one of the, I think I'm the only female Debian developer in Europe. And there's only other two girls in the world that they're Debian developers. Two, one of them, I've met one of them. And I'm going to try to speak about how I feel being a female in this world of men. I think we have little visibility, and I'm sure there are many more women out there doing free software for development, but it's only that they're doing it in the dark. And I also think we have to put this stop to the masculine view of the world and the free software. I think women have a lot to contribute to free software, and not only pink desktops, I mean real things. Like, for example, there's an image viewer called PornView. It should be offensive to women. So what I'm trying to do is making women less visible, more visible in the free software world. I'm trying to get more users interested in Debian and Linux and free software too, in technology. Because they're very good tools for goals we all have as human beings, either you're a woman or a man. What I also am trying to do is get women involved in development so that they can become more visible. I think one key thing for me to become a Debian developer is that I had a very role model that I could follow, which was my aunt. She was a computer user when I was little, and it didn't shock me too much to see women involved with computers. So that's what I'm trying to do, get more visibility and get more and make the problem be acknowledged. There's no women in technology, and eventually there will be, but I want to make that as fast as possible, or faster.